Hello, it's Michael from Red Chair Diaries, Nova Scotia, Canada, 27th of December, 2011. So, want to talk about this one, Insidious. I bought this based on so many people's recommendations. Not bad, it had some good moments in it. I was afraid it was starting to look like Poltergeist at the beginning there. But that's a convention, family moving into a house, and the kicker is the house isn't haunted, it's a child. Well, that was basically the Poltergeist theme too, even though it was built on a graveyard. Anyway, I thought it was good. I thought the performances were decent. Didn't see too much of the other two kids once one of them went in a coma. But one of the things I liked the astral projection gimmick, because I think, you know, now you're all going to laugh, we know. All of you horror fans, of course, you know, don't really believe in anything, right? But I think I used to astral project, and if I didn't astral project, I'll talk some other time about it's a very common thing where you end up with that sleep paralysis, you know. But I read two books on astral projection decades ago, Journeys Out of the Body and The Far Journey. So I still have those in here somewhere. And it's discussed exactly that sort of thing about the creatures in this other realm. They weren't necessarily human in those books that I read, you know. But anyway, the books are very, very interesting. At least they were interesting when I was in my 20s and 30s. Maybe not so much now. If you want to go look them up on the web or go to the library, one's called Journeys Out of the Body and the other one's called The Far Journey, which is the sequel to it. And I can't remember the author's name at this point, and I don't see them close by. Anyway, so I enjoyed that part of it, and the fact that the astral projection gene or chromosome or talent or whatever propensity was passed down from father to son. And I enjoyed that aspect of it very, very much. Yeah, I'll talk about this in a separate video sometime, the times that I think that I was actually astral traveling. But it's a very, very big thing in the paranormal, you know, in the psychic world. If you want to look it up, you're going to be able to find things about it. And that whole thing about, you know, being able to see yourself on in the bed and so on, pardon me, that's a big, big part of it. Anyway, to get back to the movie, for the most part I enjoyed it. I didn't think it was as spooky as several of you have said it was. But, you know, that's just the way I interpreted it. But I would recommend it. I thought it was pretty good, just the same. And just not as spooky as I thought. But let me say, since I don't really like horror movies, as in the slice and dice ones that a lot of you like, which to me are not, I don't know, are they horror? I mean, is this a horror movie? This is a ghost movie, really, I think. It's not really a horror movie, is it? And then what is horror these days? You know, is it The Mummy, which became a cartoon a few years ago, basically, you know, that series with Brendan Fraser? Say, was the Karloff one a horror movie? Is The Exorcist a horror movie or another psychological movie, a religious movie? So this, I can't say it's a horror movie, but I can say it's a spooky movie, and there's a difference. Texas Chainsaw Massacre, is that really a horror movie, or is that a true crime story? So, I don't know. Anyway, there I am. Only my fourth or fifth video around Christmas time, and I'm already off on tangents like you wouldn't believe. Anyway, I enjoyed it. I don't have a lot else to say about it. But when I see spooky things in windows, like in this movie, or, you know, doors left open after you've locked them, that sort of thing. It still works on me. It really, really works, and I really enjoy those conventions of ghost movies, spooky movies. Anyway, that's it for now. It's Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and I will see you around the tube.